Welcome back to The Race. I'm Chris Stewart, this week in Loma Linda, California. And retirement is something that people spend their entire lives preparing for. But Alicia Nieves is taking a look at why so many Americans are unretiring.
That's the bell. Here we go.
At Seminole High School in Florida, in between classes, you'll find Interim Assistant Principal Kenneth Lewis.
You're walking like your own time.
Monitoring the halls, making sure students are getting to where they need to go.
Let's go.
But just a few weeks ago, things were a lot different for Mr. Lewis. He was retired.
I'm still healthy, I can still do some things, and I can still contribute.
A growing number of people, right now nearly 40% of those who retire are unretiring and going back to work. For Lewis?
Well, the wife and I have planned to do some traveling and do some things like that and do some stuff around the house. But boy, did it get old fast.
He came out of retirement because he wanted to.
We're good.
But unfortunately, 60% of those who are unretiring are doing so because they need to.
I retired in June of 2018. I was a teacher for 21 years, and I worked for the Department of Correction for 11 years.
How different is the vision that you had for retirement versus what it actually ended up being?
My vision was to be traveling around the world, maybe somewhere in Hawaii, enjoying myself, not worrying about medical insurance.
But instead, Carol Sutton is back teaching just a year after retiring.
Go to page 6.
And that's largely because in retirement, she was getting $2,100 a month. More than a quarter of that, $600, was going towards health care.
I couldn't even imagine that I would be paying this much in insurance, health insurance. And this doesn't count the prescriptions, the doctor's appointment, the hospitalization, lab work.
Do you think you'll ever be able to actually fully retire?
I hope by the time at least I'm 65 when I'm able to get Medicare.
How are thermal vents?
The silver lining for those unretiring, whether it's because they need to or they want to, it's that in either case, they are able to.
I'm in a position where I hire from both generations and I see the benefits of both generations. The benefits of hiring the retirees, I know their work ethic. They come from a time when you committed to something, you see it through.
Many employers, from Lewis's high school to Mrs. Sutton's Christian Teaching Academy, are embracing retirees back into the workforce.
There we go. Go get them, go get them, dude.
For The Race, I'm Alicia Nieves.
As people retire, they are entitled to Social Security benefits, but we have been hearing for years that the program is on the brink of collapse. Annie Taylor has some facts.
Social Security checks help 63 million people pay their bills, but for 25 million people, those checks make up half their income. According to PolitiFact, the fund has about $2.9 trillion in it. It says without changes, that money will run out by 2035. If that happens, the program would only be able to pay 70 to 80% of expected benefits. The fund is in danger because more people are retiring and fewer people are paying in. PolitiFact put it this way, Social Security is like a pond of water. There's a stream coming in, but a full-on flow going out. Fixing the inequality could mean increasing the flow in or decreasing the flow out. The Social Security Administration says a few proposed bills would help, mostly by raising contributions. Our partners at PolitiFact found that one-third of older Americans would live in poverty without a Social Security check. I'm Annie Taylor for The Race.
The unique project to house a growing population of older Americans when The Race continues.